Good morning all of you, and today's lecture topic is Introduction of Electromagnetism. Our lecture topics are Introduction of Electromagnetism, Definition of Gradient, Curl and Divergence, Physical Interpretation of Gradient. We know that the electromagnetic force is one of the four fundamental forces. This is a process by which we create a magnetic field by using the electric current. When a conductor is electrically charged, then it generates the magnetic field lines of forces. This created electromagnetism can be turned on or turned off by cutting the electrical current. When we put the electrical current off, then the electromagnetism is also off. And when we put electrical current on, then the electromagnetism is also on. Next, gradient, divergence and curl. Gradient is defined as the maximum rate of change of any scalar function. The meaning of scalar function is that there is no dependency on direction. It is represented as del. This is the symbol of del. For example, capital T represents the temperature, then delta T is denotes the change of temperature with respect to any quantity. This quantity may be volume, distance, etc. The divergence is defined as, for a vector quantity A, is its integral over a closed surface by an infinitesimal. Meaning of infinitesimal is very, very, very small. Volume divided by that volume as the volume shrinks to zero. There is a mathematical form. Divergence A is equals to limit closed integral A dot ds upon del V, and del V tends to zero. Curl. Let consider that a small contour S, which is centered around by point L, is such as S encloses small area element ds, which is equals to n cap dot ds. As we shown in diagram, there is a S contour which is centered as L, and the small area is defined as n cap dot ds, where n cap is the unit vector. So the curl of A at point L is defined as del cross A is equals to curl A equals to limit closed integral A dot dl upon delta S. Delta S tends to zero. Consider a scalar field, and there will be two levels, A1 and A2. These levels are very close together, and their scalar function is phi and phi plus d phi. Consider two points L and M, and the coordinates for L is xyz and coordinates for M is x plus dx, y plus dy, z plus dz. And the position vector of L is r, and position vector of M is r plus dr. From diagram, Lm is equals to dr. We know that L and M, then Lm is equals to dr is equals to ax cap dx plus ay cap dy plus az cap dz, where ax cap, ay cap, az cap is the vectors and dx, dy, dz is the distance. The value of scalar function at L and M is phi and phi plus d phi. Then taking partial derivative, d phi is equals to del phi upon del x dx plus del phi upon del y dy plus del phi upon del z dz. This equation can be written as d phi is equals to del phi del x a x cap plus del phi upon del y a y cap plus del phi upon del z a z cap dot dx a x cap plus dy a y cap plus dz a z cap. When we taking dot product, then the previous equation will comes back. First term of this equation is represent as del phi, and the second term of this equation is represent as dr. This quantity del phi is known as gradient of phi. If dn represents the distance along to the normal from point L to surface A2, then from diagram dn upon dr is equals to cos theta, dn is equals to cos theta dr, dn is equals to n cap dot dr. When we solving this dot product, the cos theta will be comes. When we propagate from L to M, then phi is increased with an amount d phi. Taking the again partial derivative, d phi is equals to del phi upon del n dot dn. From equation 2, put the value of dn. D phi is equals to del phi upon del n, n cap dot dr. Now comparing equation 1 and 3, then we get del phi is equals to del phi del n dot n cap. This is the physical interpretation of gradient. This is our today's lecture. Thank you.